Welcome to BetterFit e-learning platform. My name is Edwin. Now this class is specifically for SS1, but SS3 can have it as their revision class. So last week, still remember vividly that we did water. We are still on water. Water is not a very broad topic like that. So the point that you really need is what I just brought out. I hope you are getting it. So now, I remember last week when I told you that water is a molecular compound comprising of what? Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of what? You know, oxygen. You know, bonded together covalently to the central atom there, which is what? Oxygen. So that I also wanted to tell you that water, you know, has two shared pair of electrons and two lone pair of electrons. Because of the presence of the lone pair of electrons, two lone pair of electrons that is in water molecule, that is why water. This week we are treating the hardness of what? Water. How do we know that water is hard? I know if I ask you now, how do we know that water is hard? Many of you are going to be saying so many things. Water is hard because of that, water is hard because of this. Yes, I will only give you just two reasons why we say that water is hard. Water is hard because it contains, water contains hardness because, water is hard because it contains what? Soluble what? Or dissolved salts. I said water is hard because it contains what? Dissolved salts. That's one reason. The second reason is that water is hard because it does not lather easily with what? Soup. Those are the two major reasons why we say water is said to be what? Hard. Water is said to be hard because it contains dissolved salt. One. Water is said to be hard because it's what? It's cannot lather easily with what? Soup. Those are just the major two reasons. Now, there are two types of hardness of water. The first one is temporary hardness of what? Water. And the second one is permanent hardness of water. So we are going to be taking it one after the other. So the first one here is temporary hardness of what? Water. Now, temporary hardness of water, this one is very easy because it is temporary because it can be removed by what? Simple what? Boiling. Just boil it. Once you boil, because the water is already hard because it contains what? Calcium hydrogen trihydrocarbon 4, which is a soluble trihydrocarbon 4. This calcium hydrogen trihydrocarbon 4 that is inside water, that makes the water to be what? Hard. You know, when you boil it, then something happens. Once you boil this compound, this calcium hydrogen trihydrocarbon 4 that makes temporary hardness of water to be hard, it forms an insoluble calcium trihydrocarbon 4 with water and the release of what? Carbon 4 oxide. This insoluble calcium trihydrocarbon 4, the calcium ions in it is what makes it to be what? Temporarily what? Hard. So you have to remove the calcium ions. That is why you have to boil it. So the calcium ions is to be removed as what? Precipitate. I hope you are getting it. So the calcium trihydrocarbon 4 is now removing the calcium ions that is making the water to be what? Hard. So which simply means that temporary hardness of water can be caused by calcium hydrogen trihydrocarbon 4. Hope you are seeing it, you are getting it. Good. Again, the second way we can also what remove temporary hardness is by simply using what? Slaked lime. The one you call lime water, which is calcium hydroxide. This calcium hydroxide, this slaked lime is sparingly what? Soluble in water. It's not completely soluble in water. It's sparingly what? Soluble in water. So what happens is that this calcium hydroxide trihydrocarbon 4, which is actually what caused the temporary hardness of water, is already in water. Now, if you now bring in the slaked lime, combining with it or reacting with it, it forms an insoluble calcium trihydrocarbon 4 with what? Water. This is what causes what? The temporary hardness of water, and it has to be removed by simply what? Using what? Slaked lime to remove it. So the presence of calcium ions makes what? Temporary hardness of water to be what? Hard. So it can also be, when we are treating a permanent hardness of water, you will now know the usefulness of calcium ions and magnesium ions. Why those ones, why they cause permanent hardness of water and they need to be removed. So now, we will now move over to what the effects being caused by temporary hardness of water. What are those two effects? Just two effects. Only two effects is being caused by temporary hardness of water. Only two effects. Now, the first effect we are going to look at is the falling of what kettles are what boilers. I know everybody will be reasonable. Now, what is kettles and what is boilers? It's just a simple word explanation. Now, have you ever taken time when it is raining? When it has rained for a long time and wants to rain again, do you know that that water is hard? Yes, that water is hard. All you need to do, just fetch some of this hard water, that hard water, that rain water, pour it in your kettle, you know, subject it to what? Heating. As you are heating it, make sure you cover it. As you are heating it, after some time, what happens? If you remove the cover, you are going to see some kind of white fur at the internal what surface of what the kettle. It is whitish what substance. I know you are going to be asking, what is that whitish substance? Please, that white substance that is formed at the internal part of what the kettle as you are boiling the rainwater, which is hard, is calcium trihydrocarbonate, CaCO3. This is what causes what? This one is insoluble in water. There's no way it can dissolve in water. Because if it's insoluble in water, it will just come out and then occupy the internal surface of the kettle, whatever thing or pot, whatever thing that you are using to boil the rainwater. So that white substance is caused by what? The calcium, insoluble calcium trihydrocarbonate. So that's what we mean by what? The effect of what? Falling of what? Kettles and what? Boilers. Hope you are getting me. Good. Now, the second effect we are going to look at is stalagmite and what? Stalactite. Yeah, this is the second effect. Stalagmite and what? Stalactite. Now, in a hot cave where you have hard water, as the hard water, which of course we are talking about temporary hard water, which is caused by what? Calcium hydroxide trihydrocarbonate, it is soluble. Now, in that hot cave, what happens? As water is flowing, because of the heat in that cave, what happens? The calcium hydrogen trihydrocarbonate decomposes because of that heat to form an insoluble calcium trihydrocarbonate. At a point in time, you begin to see some calcium trihydrocarbonate that is what? Growing from, that is growing downward. While some calcium trihydrocarbonate will be growing what? Upwards. Now, the calcium trihydrocarbonate in that hot cave that is growing downward is what we call stalactite. From up, growing from up to down. Very, almost like something like this. Very sharp. If you are not even careful, you might get yourself more injured. So this is what we call what? Stalactite. Because it's growing downward. Downward what? Growth. Because it's what? Growing downward. So we call it what? Stalactite. I repeat, the calcium trihydrocarbonate that is growing downward in that hot cave region is what they call stalactite. So the opposite is the stalagmite. The opposite is what? The stalagmite. The stalagmite is the one that grows what? Upwards from the bottom. It grows what? Upwards. Sharp pointed trihydrocarbonate, shapeless. This one grows what? Upwards. So this one that grows upwards is what they call stalagmite. Don't forget, for those people preparing for external exams like why can't you see, this is part of the place that you can put questions from. I hope you are. Let me repeat this. For that of stalagmite, is the calcium trihydrocarbonate that is growing downward in that hot cave. That is what we call stalactite. But the one that is growing upwards is the stalagmite. So these two effects are what you see from the temporary hardness of what? Water. So maybe next week, we will not take the brother. Since we are through with temporary hardness of water, we'll take the brother next week, which is a permanent hardness of water. How is water permanent. Permanently do what? Hard. We will know that from what? Next week. So please don't forget, these are the two effects from what? Temporary hardness of water, falling of petals and boilers, and stalagmite and what? Stalactite. And temporary hardness of water again is caused by what? Is caused by calcium hydrogen trihydroxide before it is there. So to remove it, you carefully what? Engage it to what? Simple boiling, where it will now form what? An insoluble calcium trihydroxide before, which actually makes the water to be what? Temporarily what? Hard. The presence of what? Insoluble calcium trihydroxide before, it is not soluble in water. Hope you are getting it. And this same temporary hardness of water again can also be further be removed using what? Your slaked lime, which is your lime water, which is calcium hydroxide. This is spiritless soluble in water. So here, you engage it again. What happens? The reaction takes place to form an insoluble calcium trihydroxide before, which also again, that makes the water to be what? Temporarily what? Hard. Hope you are getting it. So this is just a clearing.